Hello, it's Scott Manley here, and after yesterday's Delta launch, and indeed after every Delta 4 launch, people ask me, is that fireball that happens at launch supposed to happen? And the answer is yes, but the reason for it is of course why I'm making the video. The Delta 4 is essentially a completely different rocket from the Delta 3. It switched over to using hydrogen and oxygen as its fuel, uses RS-68 engines, and these were the first new engines developed in the US in a very long time. They were designed to be more powerful and cheaper to build than the Space Shuttle main engines. It's a bit less efficient, it uses a gas generator cycle instead of a closed cycle, it has slightly lower chamber pressure, but the RS-68 is the most powerful hydrogen-fueled engine ever built. Now the reason for the big fireball at launch is that during engine startup, for the first few seconds, they're essentially just running hydrogen through the system, and the reason is that they don't want to have oxygen getting in during the early startup, because an oxygen-rich environment or oxygen-rich pockets could damage the engine. Hydrogen is a lot less chemically active and less likely to corrode critical parts of your engine at an inopportune moment. So that hydrogen exhausts out the back of the rocket, and then being hydrogen, it rises up very quickly. And at some point, one of the sparks from the Rofes will set it on fire, and you will have this ginormous fireball which runs up the side of the rocket, typically changing its orange foam into a much browner form. This spectacular start was something that was always expected. It was designed into the system to make sure the rocket could get off the pad regardless of how toasty it got. You might be surprised to find out that all hydrogen-oxygen engines actually run fuel-rich and actually makes them more efficient. You might think that rockets would go for the maximum amount of energy to make sure that all of the oxidizer and fuel reacted. That's what's called the stoichiometric mixture ratio. Now, for hydrogen and oxygen, this would be an 8-to-1 mixture ratio, with 8 times the mass of oxygen to hydrogen. Now, the efficiency of the engine goes up as the temperature of the exhaust products get higher, but also what's important is the ability of your exhaust molecules to convert thermal energy into kinetic energy, and smaller, lighter, simpler molecules, such as molecular hydrogen, are much better at converting this thermal energy into kinetic energy. So by running a fuel-rich mixture, you end up with higher specific impulse, and it turns out that for a hydrolox engine, the ideal mixture is about 4.7 to 1. And this fuel-rich mixture actually reduces the temperature of the exhaust, which actually simplifies some of your engineering considerations. But as I mentioned, hydrogen is bulky, and having to pump a lot more of it by volume into the engine becomes harder, and it also makes your tanks larger. So the Space Shuttle main engine and the RS-68, they both run at a 6-to-1 mixture ratio. Anyway, for the fireball, there have been some attempts to mitigate this, especially on the Delta Heavy, which is essentially three Delta cores strapped together. Friday's launch of NROL 47 is notable because it's going to be the last launch of a Delta Medium on the West Coast. The non-heavy versions of the Delta are essentially being retired, so we won't see any more single cores or those with strap-on boosters, because those payloads can be effectively handled by the Atlas V, which is a lot cheaper. Liquid hydrogen may be the best rocket fuel, but it is also bulky and difficult to handle, making it very expensive. Another cost-saving feature of the RS-68 engine is evident in the colour of its exhaust. Unlike the Space Shuttle, which produces a clear blue flame, the exhaust from a Delta IV is red, and the reason for this is that the nozzle is a lot cheaper. It's not a full regeneratively cooled nozzle. The outer sections of the nozzle are graphite, designed to ablate away in the face of the heat of the chemical combustion. And of course, that carbon reacts with the hot exhaust gases to give the reddish flame. The fuel-rich fireball at the start was also cited as a problem when they were looking at human rating the Delta IV. Making the Delta IV human rated would require hundreds of changes and would make those engines a lot more expensive than they are now. So while the first launch of an Orion test capsule was done on board a Delta IV, it's unlikely that a Delta IV will actually carry any human capsule. Instead, the Atlas V is being human rated, designed to carry Boeing's Starliner in a first launch later this year. It's also worth noting that the Delta IV is currently the US's most capable launch vehicle, capable of putting just over 23 tons into low Earth orbit, making it comparable to the Russian Proton or the Chinese Long March 5. However, all of these are likely to be exceeded soon. Assuming the first launch of the Falcon Heavy isn't spectacular in the wrong way, it should be capable of putting something like 64 tons into low Earth orbit in a fully expendable manner. Of course, if it's used in a reusable manner, then it would be able to carry quite as much. But a reusable Falcon Heavy should be a lot cheaper than a Delta IV Heavy. So coming back to the original question, yes, that giant fireball at launch is entirely, as they say, nominal. And you shouldn't be advising ULA to check their staging. I'm Scott Manley, fly safe.